quite a remarkable day, really, in so many different ways. For us, it was a trial by fire there for a couple of weeks as we began. We had to kind of retool a little bit defensively and in that most difficult part of the schedule. But all I would tell you is that through some turmoil during this past season, the core group of this team stayed together the whole time. We practiced well throughout. It was a joy to be on the practice field on a daily basis, and when it required that we make some changes, in terms of who we are and who we were and who we were on the field, it just took us a little while to get that done. But we're not the team we were 6 weeks ago physically, but we've kind of come to terms with who we are, and we're better at being who we are. And so more of this responsibility was going to fall on Adam's shoulders, period. He's a senior. He's been in the goal for 4 years. He's become a leader on the field. He knows what we're trying to get done defensively as well as we do. And he helps direct traffic out there as much as anything else. And then when we had to make a couple changes and kind of retool in the middle of the field, his role became even more paramount. We just can't stop you from getting some shots. But if we can limit the quality of those shots and give him a chance to see the ball, then we feel like we're giving ourselves a chance. And so he has had a really good year for us overall, in a much bigger, more important role than he's had at any other time in his career. I'm glad that we get to kind of, I'm glad, like I say, to have it be at this moment, in this game, against that opponent, in this location, in the NCAA quarterfinals, really couldn't have been a better setting for us. It's just been a remarkable run these last few weeks, and we're really pleased that we're still playing.
For some reason, today was just our day, and the players just kept playing hard. They kept believing. They kept counting on each other. They kept battling, even though we were, in that third quarter, we knew they'd make their run, and they did. And got a couple late to kind of put us back in it. But just thrilled to be here. Thrilled to. Be moving on to the Final Four with this group of young men. They made believers out of me, that's for sure. And they just kept going hard. We thought we could get by them if we could get to those situations, but playing against the best defensive coach in the country out there, and we knew it was going to be tough. And they made adjustments at halftime that really caused us problems for a while. The biggest thing they've done all year is not do what's expected. And today, I'm sure, there weren't many, very many, except for maybe that couple of hundred in the stands that were on our side that thought that we wouldn't be ending our season today.
It's pretty overwhelming. The only ones that don't seem to get overwhelmed are the 44 guys that I coach. And so, when I watched that game today, a little of it today, you're looking at monsters out there, and they are big and athletic, and all the respect in the world to Donna. We're looking forward to the Final Four, and we're not going to go in there and be happy just to play in it, but we certainly know and respect what we're up against. And so it feels the same. It feels great. There's nothing like this winning feeling. This is why we coach. But this group of young men deserves to have their own history. They don't need it to be tied to Princeton. They need it to be tied to Denver, because that's who they are.
Man, make sure you shake their hands just like every other team.
Class. Why not, fellas?
All right, your class. You guys led a great season with the eye. All right? Really important, fellas. You'll be good at losing. Now let's be good at winning. All right? One, two, three.
Oh, wait.
We are
Denver!